What's up, Knights? We're glad you're here to watch this week's episode of The Studio.
This week, we meet with another small business owner at Higley, learn more about scholarship opportunities, and get to know two Higley alumni now working on campus.
Don't go anywhere, because The Studio starts in 3, 2...
I'm Vanessa Porter.
And I'm Sophia Riggs.
With the end of high school drawing near for many of us, Sean and Mikey took an opportunity to discuss the future with two Higley seniors who have recently signed with colleges.
Life after high school is a big decision every person has to make. Fortunately enough, we had the opportunity to speak with a few Higley athletes who have already figured it out.
Hi, my name is Brady Sieber, and recently I committed to NAU to go play lacrosse.
My name is Chloe Carpenter. I play here at Higley, and I'm going to be playing for Chandler Gilbert Community College.
Hi, my name is Ethan Schenk. I play volleyball, and I'm going to go to Benedictine University.
I think a big thing is that I'm actually able to run now. Going into lacrosse, I could not run for the life of me, but now I'm actually able to run and be able to get out there with the big body I do have.
I started playing when I was 4 or 5 years old. It was my teammates and my coaches that helped me realize that I was probably a better goalie since I wasn't as good with my feet as everybody else.
This is the culmination of hundreds, if not thousands, of hours of work when it's 115 degrees outside in the middle of the summer. And they would definitely be rather sleeping or in a swimming pool or something. Instead, they're in the weight room or on the practice field working. And I'm also thrilled as a parent, because I've been through that on the athletic side, but as a parent, it's like your greatest day.
The signing day was very emotional. I mean, my dad was crying, so it made me happy, I guess. I felt proud and I felt good about it. It felt like I did something that I didn't think I could ever do, and I did something that not a lot of people say that they could do, and it felt really good to feel like that. Because I decided to not give up, I finished this year, and now I'm able to keep going with it, and I am able to keep growing.
Really focus on, you know, your GPA, but also being a good team player and working really hard to what you want.
Don't stop, you know. You can come into this game being the absolute worst, you know, a little JV kid, and now, I mean, look at me, I'm playing varsity, and I just committed to a college. I mean, it's just kind of stay on track with it.
We wish luck to these three as they continue to pursue their athletic career. This is Mikey and Sean reporting for The Studio.
Want to try out your acting chops on our very own Higley Center Stage? Sign-ups for next year's theater classes are underway. Sign up for your audition slot outside room 759 or come by and speak with Mrs. French if you have any questions.
To celebrate Valentine's this year, Stucco spread the love by decorating the courtyard with paper hearts representing each of our students. The student union was filled with fun Valentine's puns. Thanks, Stucco, for sharing the Valentine vibe.
Students are always coming up with new innovative ways to create. Antonio and Eric sat down with Blake Ruiz, a fellow knight here, to get some insight on how he creates jewelry from household items.
Blake Ruiz, a senior at Higley, is an entrepreneur with his growing ring business. Eric and I checked it out.
My name is Blake Ruiz. My business name is _BR Customs. So I started my business back freshman year. I really needed some money, so I was on the internet. I came across a video of this guy making spoon rings. And so I was pretty intrigued with the fact that he got old silverware and made some pretty cool rings. So I started doing that, and I've been doing pretty good off since then. So I'll go to thrift stores, antique stores, yard sales, swap meets. I'll find some really cool old silverware, and then I'll make them into rings.
Blake walked us through his ring making process.
So I have this little tool that measures out different ring sizes. I'll cut the top of the spoon off, or the fork. I'll measure the length of the customer's ring size, and I'll cut that accordingly. And I'll make it a little bit more, just so when I grind it down, make it all smooth and flush, so it doesn't, you know, cut the customer's finger or whatnot. And then I go over to my workbench, get the grinder, grind out all the rough edges, and then polish it right after. From there, I'll go with some vice grips, and I'll start bending, slowly bending the ring around the socket until I get the perfect shape that I'm looking for, and that's gonna be a circle. I definitely would suggest anybody that would like to get interested in it, definitely to do it. If you guys needed help doing it too, definitely would love to help other people. Just a fun little hobby to have, and you know, something to keep you busy, you know? So students can purchase rings through my Instagram, _BRCustoms, and they can DM me and get in contact with me that way. And then if not, if you have me on Snapchat as well, definitely feel free to send me a text, and I sell them for $10, which I think is pretty reasonable, but yeah.
Feel free to contact him. This is Eric and Antonio signing out.
This week was Valentine's week. As a fundraiser, the band program delivered saxigrams to classrooms. These smooth tunes really added to the Valentine's Day cheer.
Last weekend, Chamber and Bellinoti Choirs attended NAU's 46th annual Jazz Med concert in Flagstaff. Amazing performance yet again, Knights.
Speaking of, are you interested in singing in one of Higley's top choir groups and think you can make it? Auditions for next year's group starts this week. Swing by room 758 to grab an audition packet and sign up for a time slot. You'll never know if you can make it until you try.
The boys' volleyball season is starting up soon. James spoke to our new coach and a few players to find out what we can expect from the team.
Practice for boys volleyball started up this week, and the program plans to continue progressing.
I think last year was kind of tricky just because we had a new coaching staff, and it was just pretty crazy for the team.
Last season, it was a good season for us to build off of, and we're trying to carry the momentum from last year's into this year.
So a couple of the things, you know, that we're looking to improve on. Obviously, how far we go into the playoffs, that's kind of one of the big things that, you know, I want to come in here and kind of set as a standard and expectation is that Higley Volleyball is going to be playing, you know, in first week, second week of May. I'm really looking to implement like a really good system, high level system, stuff that, you know, is being taught in college and at the professional levels that the boys can run with.
The team is ambitious for the upcoming season.
I just wanted to like try and make it to state. I mean, it'd be cool. Like, it's my senior year.
I think we have a really decent chance, actually a pretty good chance at going to the state tournament.
It's like the same kids I started the program with, I'm going to end with. So it'd be a really good memory for us.
We love fans at our games. It just makes the whole gym feel really energized, and we play better.
If you know, if you come out, you'll have a great time, and it's something you're not going to regret.
It's important for our fans to pop out just because it motivates us to like have like a better game, and like we really honestly we get the like the crowd involved in the games, and we're not like a really bad team, but we were pretty good this year, so yeah, it'll be fun to watch.
Remember to check the HHS event calendar for game dates and come support our Knights as they go for state.
Like a G6.
Congratulations to the following wrestlers for qualifying for the state tournament: Drake Walton, Brendan Northern, Ronan Richardson, Michael Mulvena, Nick Carroll, Canyon Crowther, Inez Tidwell, and Cedro Guillen. They will be all wrestling today and tomorrow at Veterans Coliseum.
Boys varsity basketball defeated the Castile Colts Wednesday night by a score of 72-60 to move on in the playoffs. Congrats, boys. Let's get another dub this Saturday versus Buena.
Also, a special congratulations to both Winter Guard and the Winter Drumline for their successful first competition over the weekend. Both groups earned second place in their division. Today, the Drumline will be competing at Williamsfield. Good luck, Knights.
On Wednesday, Best Buddies held a lunch party where they celebrated Valentine's Day by creating and coloring their own gnomes.
Some people can't get enough of the high school experience. Former students Tommy Caprice and Caden Miller recently returned to the Higley community, this time as members of the staff. Vanessa and Christelle spoke with them to find out more about their return to the kingdom.
High school is an experience that is unique to each individual. Tommy and Caden discovered they enjoyed there so much that they returned, but this time to take up the role of leading students instead.
Right now at Higley High School, I am a coach for the boys varsity soccer team, and I work a little bit with the JV team as well, and I just assist with the boys soccer program and everything that goes along with that.
I am a long-term substitute, so I have a set schedule every day. I teach 3 math classes and then a science and another math class at the end of the day.
Though there are many reasons they like their jobs, one aspect particularly stood out to them.
My favorite part about working here is just being able to see how much Higley's changed and being able to interact with all the younger kids. I just like helping people, that's why I want to be a doctor.
I think my favorite part of my job is just being able to interact with the players and the students at the school in a competitive environment.
Having connections definitely came into play, enabling them to get the job, which they found they enjoyed as it was a means to stay in touch with their passions.
So my mom actually works at the district office, and she presented me with this opportunity, and she said it would be a good learning experience for my future career, and so I decided to take it.
So I wanted to do this job because soccer is a big passion of mine. I actually knew the coach, the head coach of the varsity team. He was my coach when I was a player, and asked him if I could kind of take on this role as the assistant coach. And you know, he was all for it, and so I kind of learned under him last year, my first year, and I couldn't wait to get back, and I knew all the same kids when I came back this year, so.
Overall, it has been a pleasant experience for them.
It's been great working at Higley.
I like working and teaching kids, especially like in subjects that I'm good at.
I think if you have the opportunity to go work at Higley High School after you graduate to do anything at all, I think you should probably take it, because the staff and teachers here are all very, very helpful and supportive.
Make sure you greet them when you see them around campus and ask them about their occupations.
This has been Christelle and Vanessa. Peace out. Well, Knights, thank you for tuning in with us. That's all we've got for you this week.
Make sure to follow us on Instagram at the Studio HHS and have a great 3-day weekend, Knights.